Acts chapter number 8.
Dito lokala mora magubete.
And verse number 1.
Mga temanin yan po.
Are you there?
Alitin mo.
The Bible reads.
Bakit ka nahiro?
And Saul was consenting unto his death.
Me Paulo o nasa brera kan sports na sa rabo.
He was agreeing with his death.
Ana chumala na dili sa rabo.
And at that time there was a great persecution against the church, which was at Jerusalem.
Me karabo kono kono na kalo yensi ya kereke dino kono Jerusalem.
And they were all scattered abroad throughout the regions of Judea and Samaria. Except the apostles. And devout men kept Stephen to his burial and made great lamentation over him. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 8, verse number 1. And Saul was consenting unto his death. And at that time there was a great persecution against the church which was at Jerusalem. And they were all scattered abroad throughout the regions of Judea and Samaria. Except the apostles. And devout men carried Stephen to his burial. And made great lamentation over him. For Saul, he made havoc of the church. Entering into every house and hating men and women, committed them to prison. Therefore, they that were scattered abroad went everywhere preaching the word. Lift your hands, say, Lord Jesus. Come on, say, Lord Jesus. I thank you for your word that is coming with power and revelation in my life, in the name of Jesus. Can you say amen? Can you say amen? Hallelujah. Something happened in the early church. The Bible talks about the early church. But this church was a united church. They were always in one place. And the Bible says everything they had, they were sharing among themselves. If someone has got food, they bring the food to the church. And they will share with others. And they will not regard anything to be of themselves. They were sharing. And they were excited. It was a wonderful life indeed. Hallelujah. But on the side of God, God was not happy with everything they were doing. They were in one place worshiping God, sharing food, and excited every day. Hallelujah. But now, because of that, the gospel could not reach other areas. Because they were comfortable. They were so relaxed where they were. They were not challenged of going to other areas and preach the gospel. These disciples and those who got born again in their time. So for them to go out, God allowed persecution. There was a man called Saul, who is now called Paul. The Bible says this man, he will carry a horse and get some chains. If you worship Jesus, he will tie you to his horse and drag you with the horse because you believed in Jesus. Then he will take you and put you into prison. Hallelujah. He did not believe in Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody shall
amen.
He did not believe in Jesus. He was believing in the law. He was one of those people who believed that Jesus Christ was not born. Like the Jews. You know, the Jews, even today, they are still waiting for the coming of Jesus Christ. Even though Jesus came some 2,000 years back, the Jews are still waiting for the coming of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So Paul was one of those guys. He believed that Jesus was not born at that time. He was someone who was standing on the law. And according to the law, he had to get those who were not believing preaching Jesus and put them into prison. Hallelujah. Somebody shall amen. When you read the Bible, he said, according to the law, he was found guiltless. Hallelujah. He was found guiltless according to the law. Somebody shall amen. So God used Paul and some of the Jews to persecute the church. Hallelujah. When the church was persecuted, now the church began to get from one place to another. They began to scatter around and begin to preach the gospel where they were going. Hallelujah. Because they were persecuted where they were. So they were forced to go out and preach the gospel. Hallelujah. So when I was preparing to come here, the Lord gave me this message to say, you know, sometimes when persecutions comes into our life, when people begin to treat us in a bad way, when things begin to be wrong in your life, sometimes it is God allowing those things deliberately to show you that your time in that place is over. So you need to go and go to another place. Yes, somebody shall amen. Because sometimes we
stay in one place for a long time. Not knowing that we need to move. We need to move. Hallelujah. So sometimes God uses challenges. He uses problems. You know, satisfaction sometimes can make you to miss God. Because you are too satisfied. Hallelujah. So the disciples were just in one place. They were enjoying life. There was no problem at all. They were so satisfied with what they were experiencing at that time. But God had more for them. Hallelujah. Sometimes we don't realize that there is much for us. There is more for us that God has in store for us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you are blessed,
house of faith.
Can I tell you something? According to God, you are not blessed enough. There are still more blessings that God wants to bring in your life. There are still more blessings that God wants to bring in your life. It is not enough. There is more of God's anointing that you want to bring in your life. So sometimes God allows problems. He allows us to go through situations. He does that deliberately. So that we may wake up from our sleep. Because sometimes we sleep a lot. Sometimes we relax a lot. And we forget that there is more that God wants us to do. The disciples were so relaxed. They were so comfortable where they were. But God wanted them to go around the world and preach the gospel. Hallelujah. So he allowed persecutions. He allowed problems to come among them. So that they may wake up from their sleep. If you are going through problems in 2015, God was just waking you up from your sleep. Tell your neighbor, God was just waking you up from your sleep. If someone is sleeping, sometimes take cold water and pour on them. They will wake up. Hallelujah. So it allows problems to wake us up from our sleep. I tell you, no sleep in 2016. I'm saying no sleeping in 2016. Tell your neighbor, no sleeping in
2016.
Hallelujah. So the moment problems came, the disciples went around and preached the gospel. But without problems, they couldn't go anywhere. Hallelujah. You know, if you have a child and you give them everything, they will forget to look for a job. But the moment they begin to lack some other things, they will begin to look for a job. Hallelujah. But if you give them everything, they won't even look for a job. Hallelujah. So God used the problems so that they may wake up from this. Philippians chapter 1 from verse number 12. Amen. The Bible says Paul caused the havoc. He went from house to house, killing Christians. And Christians have to run away. They went to other areas. When they got there, they preached the gospel. Hallelujah. Sometimes to go through problems is good, makes you wiser. It makes you wiser. Amen. If you are a man or a woman and you stay in your mother's house, when are you going to buy your own bed? When are you going to buy your own clothes? So sometimes going out makes you wise. Hallelujah. Going out makes you what? Wise. Amen. Philippians 1 verse 12. Are you there? But I would you should understand, brethren, that the things which happened unto me have fallen out rather unto the furtherance of the gospel. Hallelujah. Can you see what Paul is saying? He said the things that happened to him, they came to him in order to further the gospel. Hallelujah. Some of the things that happened to you, they happened to you so that the gospel may be furthered. Hallelujah. He said, so that my bones in Christ are manifest in all powers, all the powers, and in all the other places. And many of the brethren in the Lord, waxing confidence by my bones, are much more bold to speak the word without fear. Hallelujah. You know, there was a time when Paul was bound. He was in chains. He was prisoned. And the Bible says, Paul is saying, when I was in those bonds, when I was in those chains, many of the brethren in the Lord became confident. Confident to preach the gospel. The reason why God makes me as a pastor to go through problems. God can make me to go through problems deliberately. Because he will be teaching you a lesson to see me going through problems and going out of those problems, so that you may be confident the day you enter into problems. You will know that as long as my man of God was in problems and he got out of this problem, I will also get out of those problems. Hallelujah. Somebody shout amen. Don't follow a man of God who has never made a mistake in life.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout amen. Oh, he has never gone through challenges in life.
Somebody
shout amen. You need to follow someone who has gone through problems. As a church, we must go through challenges sometimes. We must go through challenges sometimes. And look at us. Are we going to faint? Or are we going to rise when we are going through challenges? Don't trust a church that has never gone through challenges. Trust a church that went through problems and they got out of those problems. Paul says, I was in chains so that those who were following me, the Bible says they were now confident. Hallelujah. They were confident when they saw Paul in chains and he kept on preaching the gospel. Can I tell you something? It doesn't matter how many challenges you go through. If you are a husband and a wife and you are going through problems, hold on. Hold on. I'm saying hold on. Don't give up your marriage. Don't give up. Hallelujah. You must be able to tell your children tomorrow. You need to be able to tell them, I was in the same problem and I managed to come out. I managed to come out. Most of you in 2015, you have been going through challenges. God was preparing you. He was making you a teacher. He was making you a counselor. So that you may tell others that my brother, hold on.